From all of us here at the Master of Legal Studies and Bachelor of Arts in Law program to the class of 2020 and 2021, congratulations on a job exceedingly well done. Under the very hardest of circumstances, you have succeeded, and we're also very proud of you. Bear down.
Bear down. Congratulations.
Congrats. We're the Global Programs team at the College of Law, and we are here to congratulate the class of 2021 on your graduation.
We want to give a special shout out to all of our international students.
The college takes great pride in the number of international students we have. And this year's graduating class includes international students from most of our degree programs.
Like the MLS.
The LLM.
The JD.
The SJD.
And you truly represent every part of the world.
Such as Cambodia.
China.
Colombia.
Germany.
India.
Iran.
Japan.
Kenya.
Mexico.
Nigeria.
Pakistan.
Saudi Arabia.
Serbia.
South Korea.
Spain.
Tanzania.
Ukraine.
And Vietnam.
This last year has been challenging for all students, but many of our international students have also faced the stress of being separated from their families for much of the year.
We hope you get together with your families very, very soon to celebrate your success.
So, to the class of 2021,
congratulations.
To the class of 2021, you know, all of you entered Arizona law in the fall of 2018, just as I did. And then all of you had to find your place in our law school community over the last 3 years, just as I had to. And it's because of that connection that I will always look back on your class with great fondness and pride. It's been so much fun to get to watch you develop from that first semester in law school into the amazing advocates you now are. And I'm filled with so much hope for the future of our legal profession. I know that you are more than up to the task of helping other people with some of the most difficult problems they will ever face. I can't wait to see what you all do next. Congratulations.
Congratulations to Innovation for Justice leadership students, Gabriella, Jackie, and Garrick, and to all of the students graduating today who have come through the Innovation for Justice Lab in their time at Arizona Law. Thank you for all that you've done to improve access to justice in our community and in other communities. Please keep in touch, and please keep changing the world.
Jackie, Gabriella, and Garrick, congratulations on your graduation. It has been so amazing to see all of the great things you've done for I4J and the law school at large, and I'm so excited to see what amazing things you all do in your future.
Hi, Gabriella, Jackie, and Garrick. Congratulations on graduation. You did it. I'm so grateful that I was able to get to know each and every one of you through Innovation for Justice this year. You've taught me so much, and your friendship has been invaluable. I'm so excited to see what good you do in the world after graduation, and I can't wait to keep up with you. Congratulations again. It's over. You did it.
Congratulations, class of 2021. What a journey we've had. Together and on Zoom, you're a wonderful class, so many terrific people. I'm looking forward to see your careers develop. Do good things with your manifold talents, your training, your hands and your hearts. Stay close to each other and please stay close to us as well as you go on your journey. And I hope you all take time to really celebrate. Take an admiration break now. You've worked hard and you've made it. My blessing to you is may you be present in what you do. May you never become lost in the bland absences. May dawn find you awake and alert, approaching your new day with dreams, possibilities, and promises. And may evening find you gracious and fulfilled. Thank you for being with us these past few years, and take care.
Congratulations, Arizona Law Class of 2021. We are all so proud of you. Graduating from law school is a remarkable achievement in the best of times, let alone when you have so many other things drawing your attention, resources, and willpower. You've accomplished something that few people would have the strength to do, and I hope you give yourselves credit for this and find time to celebrate. And of course, we in the Career Office are always here for you whenever you need any help going forward.
Hi, class of 2021. Congratulations. We're so happy for you. Please come visit us.
Congratulations, class of 2021. It's been so great getting to know so many of you. Please stay in touch.
Class of 2021, you made it through an extraordinarily challenging year, but you did it. Congratulations to all of you. The CDO wishes you the best in your future endeavors.
Congratulations, class of 2021. Can't wait to see all the amazing things you do.
Orion and I would like to offer a heartfelt congratulations to the class of 2021. It's been a crazy year, but you did it. You survived. So bravo, and all of us at CDO wish you luck in all of your future endeavors. Bear down.
On behalf of Arizona Law Clinics, we want to wish all of you graduates a huge congratulations for your accomplishment today. This is the icing on your cake for your years of hard work, your final exams, your writing projects, your clinical accomplishments, your externships, and your virtual classes.
We want to give a special shout out to all of our clinic students who are able to creatively practice law and represent clients. We are proud of you and wish you the best of success as you start your next adventures.
Congratulations from the IP clinic in particular. I know it's been a tough year, and in addition to being very proud of you, I know you're gonna do great things with whatever comes next.
It has been a privilege and an honor to work with you. And I know that whatever you do, you can face every single challenge that comes your way. Please don't be a stranger. Keep in touch and let us know about the amazing things that you're doing.
Shout out to all the Immigration Law Clinic grads and the Community Immigration Law Placement Clinic grads. You guys worked really hard. You developed skills that will help you heal the world. So I hope you use them that way and also heal yourselves. Have great careers. Stay in touch. We're proud of you.
Well, this is my 50th graduation at the University of Arizona. And every class is unique, and that is true of yours as well. I know it's a difficult year or two for you and all of us, but we appreciate your taking part in our clinical programs, and of course, for me, especially the Civil Rights Clinic. So I want to wish you luck and power to you.
Congratulations.
Congratulations. Shout out to the Veterans Advocacy Law Clinic graduates, Mario in Arizona and Nick. Good job, guys.
Congratulations to all of our amazing clinic students. Way to go, Law Cats, class of 2021.
I know. Sean's is just the classic.
He wins.
Hey, babe, can you give me a corgi?
Oh, yes, Travis.
Ready? Are we ready?
We're ready.
All right. One, two, three.
Congratulations!
From your law library.
Congratulations!
Hello, Arizona Law Class of 2021, and congratulations on your graduation. I know I speak for all the legal writing professors when I say that we wish you the very best as you embark upon this next stage in your legal career. We will miss you very much. I can't say that you'll miss us all that much, because as you'll soon find out, we'll be. Remember,
you want to fully develop the law before you apply it to the facts of our case.
Words mean something. Words are an attorney's currency. So if you don't know what a word means, look it up before putting it in your paper.
If you say it in 40 words and I can say the same thing in 20 words, I win. Brevity promotes clarity.
Judgment just has one E.
Do not write case book reports. Your reader doesn't care.
So if there's one thing this class should have learned from the escape room, it's that periods and commas always go inside quotation marks. Always, always, always.
Don't forget, show, don't tell.
Be persuasive. Be persuasive. There's a reason I was never a cheerleader.
Make the relationship between ideas transparent for your reader by using transitions. These are road signs for your reader. And if you have three reasons, use first, second, and third.
Remember, don't substitute strong language for strong reasoning.
Legal writers do not substitute as for because.
If I have to take a breath in the middle of reading your sentence, it's probably too long.
We know you are all going to be amazing lawyers. Just trust your training. And when all else fails, remember, we'll be in your heads. Congratulations.
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 Thank you. We love you.
All right, everyone ready?
Hello, law graduates. It's been a true joy to work with you over the past 3 years. You are an amazing group of students. You've weathered the pandemic. You've kept your nose to the grindstone. Many of you have dealt with difficult family circumstances. Some of you have been at home homeschooling with little children. I admire you so much. And there is just an amazing future ahead of you. I wish you all the best. Happy graduation.
Class of 2021, good evening and welcome. How about that? At least you'll always remember where you were when you went through your graduation ceremony. Tonight we celebrate the University of Arizona's 157th commencement and the James E. Rogers College of Law 2021 convocation. This has been a year of tremendous challenges answered by extraordinary resilience. We recognize the efforts made by countless people at the university and around the world to adapt and to sustain us all. Thank you.
Buenas tardes. Bienvenidos a la Universidad de Arizona. Hoy celebramos el 157 aniversario de la graduación de la Universidad de Arizona y el 2021 convocatoria de Colegio de Derecho de James E. Rogers. A nuestra familia de Wildcats y los graduados que nos acompañan esta noche desde todo Arizona y el mundo, gracias por unirse a nuestra celebración. Este ha sido un año de tremendos desafíos respondidos por una extraordinaria resiliencia. Reconocemos los esfuerzos realizados por innumerables personas en la universidad y en todo el mundo para adaptarnos y sostenernos a todos. Gracias.
If you are able, please rise and remove your caps for a special version of the national anthem performed earlier by three graduating musical theater BFA seniors, Cameron Elias, Jenna Meadows, and Tony Moreno, directed by Christy Kerr and Jamie Reed, and the flag is on this side of the auditorium.
Say, can you see by the dawn's early light what so proudly we hailed at the twilight's last gleaming? Whose broad stripes and bright stars we watched were so gallantly streaming,
and the rocket's red glare, the bombs bursting in air,
gave proof through the night that our flag was still there. Oh, say, does that star-spangled banner yet wave?
O'er the land of the free,
land of the free, and the home of the brave.
Please be seated.
President Robbins, you said we'd be back in person, and here we are. Let's welcome these Wildcats. Good evening, Wildcats.
Dean Miller, I couldn't be happier to be here in the Cole and Jenny Davis Sports Center tonight with so many of our students. I think we have about 160 students tonight for Arizona Law.
I think that deserves a round of applause.
Absolutely. As we celebrate here on this beautiful campus, we respectfully acknowledge the University of Arizona is on unceded land of Indigenous peoples. Today, Arizona is home to 22 federally recognized tribes, with Tucson being home to the Odom and Paskayaki. Committed to diversity and inclusion, the university strives to build sustainable relationships with Arizona's Native nations and tribal communities through educational offerings, partnerships, and community service. Our actions will recognize the past and lay the foundation for all future Indigenous students. To all of the Wildcat family and graduates watching tonight and throughout Arizona and around the world, thank you for joining our celebration. Graduates, this evening is for you to recognize all of your hard work and accomplishments. Enjoy it.
This is a time to give thanks for everything we have and for the people who have dedicated themselves to make our lives better. First, we would like to thank our veterans, active duty, guard, and reserve students in attendance with us tonight for their service to this nation. And we can't tell you how thankful we are for all of the people on the front lines of this pandemic. From first responders to all of you who have stayed home, masked up, volunteered, gotten vaccinated, thank you.
We're especially proud of Arizona faculty members for their flexibility, working with students online and in person. Our researchers who have developed COVID-19 tests for individuals and whole housing complexes, our vaccine pod volunteers, and in particular, our facilities team, whose incredible dedication and foresight has translated into a vaccine freezer farm, the smooth operation of the university's vaccination pod, and the continuity and excellence in operations for the entire campus through these very difficult times. Wildcats adapt and bear down.
To our governing body, the Arizona Board of Regents, who work tirelessly to lead, promote, and protect our university and all it stands for, we thank you. As a point of pride, we have two Arizona Law graduates currently serving as regents. Regent Kate Hackett King is an employment and labor attorney, as well as the governor's former deputy general counsel. And Regent Bill Ridenour, former aide to Senators Barry Goldwater and Paul Fannin, is a business and finance attorney and a staunch, longtime supporter of our college and its graduates. JD candidate this year, Lauren LeCure, recently completed a term. As service as a student regent. What a unique, extraordinary set of challenges you have faced and you now face going forward. Studying the law takes substantial time and focus. It is not easy. Any disturbance in the force, challenges at home with families and partners, and friends with health, with finances, can make legal study so much more complex. But the challenges you have faced, some common to our world, like COVID, others shared throughout our country, like the horrific murder of George Floyd, and the larger racial and social reconciliation of which those long 9 minutes and the conviction of his killer are a part, some unique to our college, were not in the realm of what we could foresee. On the first and most global of those challenges, we will never forget the burdens of COVID. Nor, for one, will I ever forget the elegance of your response, the adaptability to a mode of education none of us chose as the primary learning tool, pushing back against the barriers to making and sustaining key friendships, the message about community so beautifully captured in what you said, what you wrote, and what you did. But here is one of my key messages. COVID will not define you. I believe that COVID and the noisy political and community landscape that has defined recent years will not be a lasting weight on your shoulders. They will be instructive. By dint of experience, you are positioned to adapt, to lead, to illustrate and embody how we listen across boundaries, how we work to expand our ability to understand others, to appreciate the immense diversity of views, perspectives, people, and politics in our society, to empathize. Universities and colleges are a microcosm of our larger society, but with a critical difference. Universities and our law school have structures and settings, whether classes or clinics, our courtyard, the library, the mall, here in the Davis Center, where we gather, speak, and listen. Members of universities overwhelmingly accept the idea that facts, sources, and methods matter, that no one has absolute or perfect knowledge, that people and policies and the understanding of best practices can change, that many choices by people and institutions reflect value choices, different paths and principles about which reasonable people can, basing their judgment on facts and science, still differ. That communities are complex, and being a member of a community takes work. At times past, many of these ideas were shared more broadly in our country and communities. I don't mean all voices were heard. I don't assert the legal system's goals of justice and equality and due process were or are achieved as much as we should hope and want. We should always be in pursuit of a more perfect union. I do mean that with your legal training and the challenges you have faced, you are well positioned to help not only mend, but to improve our larger communities. That is no small task. But you have already demonstrated you are the people to do it. Congratulations. And from my heart, thank you.
Anyone who perseveres their higher education goals, especially graduate education, has demonstrated dedication and forward thinking, but I cannot emphasize enough how proud of you we are for working so hard through unprecedented challenges to reach this day. This past year, I've been so impressed with our Wildcats. I've seen our students' compassion for helping one another, for serving the community, and doing everything they can to help all of us get through the pandemic. I've seen your innovative spirit working side by side with our faculty experts to find solutions to the challenges brought on by COVID-19. And I've seen you achieve your personal and academic goals through one of the most difficult times in recent history. Many people have said, it's not whether you get knocked down, it's whether you get up. This year, the University of Arizona community showed the world we know how to get back up. The class of 2021 not only has proven they can get up, they've shown all of us how to persevere, adapt, and move into a bright future in the face of great uncertainty. No matter what you go on to do with your lives, I want everyone in this class to remember, you know how to get back up and keep pressing forward to make the world simply a better place. I know you will go on to do the amazing things that we have envision for you, and that you will create a positive impact throughout the world, no matter what you choose to do. As you do, know that our Wildcat family is behind you. We are proud of you. We are in awe of what you have accomplished and what you will do next. And now I would like to turn the evening over to Dean Miller.
Thank you, President Robbins. I would like to take a moment to introduce those here on the platform with me. Lauren Easter, MLS candidate.
You might, if you can,
you may want to stand up when I call you so people know who's here. Delorean Forbes, JD candidate. Katie Derrig, JD candidate. Jingyuan Zhou, SJD candidate. Paulene Abeyta, JD candidate. Angela Woolridge, our 2002 alumna and Law College Association president. Sarah Myers, Student Bar Association president. Paloma Melo-Haro, MLS candidate. Dr. Willie Jordan Curtis, Assistant Dean of Student Affairs. Professor Kathy Barnes, our Associate Dean for Programs and Innovation. Professor Keith Swisher, Director of the BA in Law and Master's in Legal Studies Program. Professor Mona Immel, who serves in the UA Faculty Senate. And Mike Brooks, Registrar and Assistant Dean of Academic Affairs. I also want to introduce another very distinguished group that has played a critical role in the lives of today's graduates. Will representatives of the faculty here tonight please rise and be recognized? Finally, I would like to recognize the most important guests of all, those who provided the love and support that made your success possible. Graduates, would you join me if you can on your feet and give a wildly enthusiastic thanks to friends and family members watching here and all over the world. The study of law is a collective enterprise. Now, graduates, today may mark your last day as students, but it will mark, for some of you, your first as alumni, where you can rely on a strong and supportive Bear Down network, as well as a worldwide group of College of Law alumni and University of Arizona alumni who have your back. Please give a warm welcome to Law College Association President and member of the class of 2002, Angela Woolridge.
President Robbins, Dean Miller, honored guests, family and friends, and of course, class of 2021, congratulations on your remarkable achievement. An achievement that is all that more extraordinary when considering all of the changes, all of this uncertainty, all of the, let's face it, downright weirdness that you've had to endure throughout this latter half of your legal education. But you have persevered, you have adapted, and you have thrived. And now you begin your legal careers that much stronger as a result. Now, as each of you embarks on your own journey, there are three thoughts I'd like to send with you. First, be true to yourself. Find your passion, find what gives you purpose, and make it your career. Perhaps it's helping others, breaking down barriers, being intellectually challenged. No matter what career path you choose, make sure it allows you to pursue what is important to you. Don't be afraid to try something new, unexpected, untraditional, to change paths along the way, or to create your own path. You've already proven your ability to adapt. Now use that ability to find your true calling. It may not be the first road you choose or the career you envisioned your first day here at Arizona Law, but there is a unique joy in doing what you love, in doing what gives you purpose, And my hope for each of you is that you get to experience that joy. Second, no matter what path you choose, treat one another well. Be civil. In a profession characterized by an adversarial system, it is far too easy to forget that we are all colleagues, we are all human. Be considerate, be courteous, be respectful to everyone you deal with. Even if they don't extend the same courtesy to you, be the bigger person, set the right example. Our profession has long been plagued with a reputation for hostility and animosity. Help us change this. Help us move in the right direction. Embrace civility in all that you do, and I promise you, not only will you have a positive impact on the legal profession, but you'll feel a lot better and you'll be a lot happier in your career. Third and finally, don't forget that even though you graduate today, you are still a part of Arizona law. Today, you join more than 7,000 Arizona Law alumni who constitute a growing global presence, who lead because they are prepared to, who serve because they are called to, and who strengthen their communities every day in countless ways. On behalf of the Law College Association, of which each of you are now a member, I welcome you and invite you to stay connected to us. Mentor a law student, participate in on-campus interviews, this time as an employer rather than a student. Help raise money for a scholarship and stay connected. Support our college as it educates, prepares, and empowers professionals who, like you, will continue to change the world. Thank you, and again, congratulations, graduates, and congratulations to the family and friends who supported you and made your incredible accomplishment possible.
Thank you, Angela. We are particularly fortunate to have strong leadership in both the alumni body and in the student body. Joining us is SBA President Sarah Myers.
Thank you, Dean Miller. It has been a great honor to serve as your Student Bar Association president this past year, despite the challenges that none of us could have foreseen. Thank you all for giving me this opportunity. And for those of you I've had the pleasure of working closely with, thank you for your unending patience and support. While our class is difficult to sum up in a few words, we will surely be leaving our mark on Arizona law. As someone once said, what a long, strange trip it's been. At the culmination of this journey, we have the opportunity to give back in a way that is symbolic of our shared experiences here through our class gift campaign. Because we understand the importance of finding a healthy balance while in law school, this year, our graduating class established the Student Mental Health Fund in order to increase the mental health services offered to students at the College of Law. I am pleased to announce that as of the start of this ceremony, we have raised $3,268.52. But we're not done yet. Until midnight tonight, graduating 3L and SBA Vice President Brian Truby has graciously agreed to match all donations up to $5,000. I am so proud of all the work we have accomplished here, and I look forward to seeing what we will accomplish going forward. Congratulations to the class of 2021. One way or another, we have made it to the finish line. Thank you all.
Over the last few years, Arizona Law has been a national leader in expanding legal education. Our BA in Law program, along with the Masters of Legal Studies program, are now well established, and they train new types of legal professionals to serve a growing global need. The Masters of Legal Studies class of 2021 has selected Lauren Easter as their speaker. Like many of you, Lauren has worked tenaciously to be here today, a setting that looked next to impossible at the age of 24, when she left an abusive situation to, in her words, be a role model for my son. And while Lauren completed her studies online, she was a fully engaged member of our community, blazing a trail for other MLS students. Please welcome Lauren Olivia Easter.
Thank you, Dean Miller, for that wonderful introduction. Good evening, everyone. My name is Lauren Olivia Easter, and it is my great honor to have been elected as your MLS class speaker this evening. First, I would like to give a huge thank you to all of the staff, faculty, and administrators who have not only supported us on our journey, but have also put together this commencement so that we may celebrate our achievements together as we should be. We have heard it over and over again that these are troubled and unprecedented times. With the amount of injustice, separation, and the tremendous loss of loved ones to this pandemic, I know I am not the only one who has found it difficult to sleep at night. For those of you who do not know me, I am a survivor of domestic violence. And I remember a time when I was speaking with my advocate and was voicing my concerns about how I would ever get back on my own two feet, especially with the statistics you read. And at that moment, she said to me, "Lauren, you will be your own statistic." And that sentence resonates with me to this day. That is what we have all done here. We are redefining the expectations society might have for us. Whether you are a person of color, a single mother, a fellow survivor, whatever adversity you have faced, remember that you are here and you should be proud. Together, we have all persevered. And do you know why? Because we are wildcats and we will always bear down, no matter the challenges we endure. Sure, we may have complained or even cried, but we did not quit. We did not give up, because we know this will not continue to be our reality. Each one of us are fighters, not only because of the love we have for wanting to chase our dreams, but for the love we have for one another. This community at James E. Rogers is strong, and this community will continue to be strong. That love that we have shines bright, and I mean so bright that I can feel it standing right here before you. And I know that light will continue to shine even brighter after tonight. So congratulations, all of the MLS, MPS, JD, LLM, SJD, and certificate graduates of 2021. I know that this is not the end, but it is only our beginning. The beginning of us harnessing all of the work, all of the values, all of the skills that we have embodied, and using them on whatever our next endeavor may be. We are leaving here tonight with so much love, so much compassion, and so much empathy that I know all of us are going to do great things in this world, because we are prepared and we are ready. And this world needs leaders like us more than ever to rebuild this foundation we all stand upon. I am so eager to see the impacts you will have, and please know that I am cheering you all along the way. I am so exceptionally proud of each and every one of you. And congratulations once again, bear down.
Thank you, Lauren. Our LLM and SJD programs have chosen Jingyuan Zhou as their speaker, known to us informally as Joey. Jingyuan's enthusiasm was evident when she arrived on campus seeking an American JD after earning, indeed with a stellar record, her first law degree in China. Joey continued to pursue her studies and become a fine scholar and teacher. Joey.
Thank you. Good evening. It is a great honor to be here to represent students in the Doctor of Juridic Science (JD) and Master of Laws (LLM) programs and the international student body here at the College of Law. Our time here has been extraordinary. I feel all too sudden when today the graduation finally comes, even after spending 4 years here at the College of Law doing my JD, and not to mention another 3 years of JD and LLM here. Yes, you hear this right. After 7 years, I call the College of Law home, Tucson, my adopted hometown. Despite that I come from a small, tiny city in China with about 30 million people, half a world away. So what do I make of my years here? An acronym best describes HOPE, H-O-P-E. Why HOPE? Let me explain. H stands for help and humbleness, O for open-mindedness and outstanding, P for pragmatism and positivity, and E for endeavor and empathy. Let me expand a little bit more. Tucson offers a quite different culture, and not to mention the hot weather and the cacti than my hometown. And as my fellow classmates from other parts of the world, Asia, Africa, Oceania, the European Union, and the Americas can attest, it takes a lot of courage and determination to take on this adventure. I had spent countless days and nights reading, preparing for finals and activities as a moot court, and revising and rewriting briefs and theses. But I never, ever, at one moment, felt alone. Why? Because of the fabulous people here. They all magically share the characters that I described in the acronym, HOPE. Starting with my classmates and friends. Despite our different backgrounds, we share curiosities about each other and genuinely care for each other. We encourage each other and support each other. We compete together and we prosper together. I, like you, has been supported by superb administrative staff members here, who are always attentive and ready to help. Their care helped me navigate through many challenges and made my time here more enjoyable. I'm also inspired by professors and mentors whose wisdom always sheds light on me. And my special thanks goes to Professor Sergio Puig, my academic advisor and mentor for life, whose tremendous mentorship has and will continuously inspire me throughout my career. This is a snapshot of HOPE. I'm very grateful to have spent a significant portion of my life here at the College of Law. It enables students like you and me, domestic and international, with different backgrounds and cultures to flourish and succeed. It helps us to understand and explore the world. It encourages us to make positive contributions to the greater society. It has done so through a great vision of inclusivity, open-mindedness, and pragmatism. The world is inextricably interconnected and diverse. The College of Law, one of the most innovative and globally focused law schools in the world, through its robust LLM and HJD programs and the global programs, reflects such diversity. Here, on behalf of the HJD students and the global programs, I extend our special appreciation to the great leadership team at the College of Law. Thank you, Demeter, for carrying out this great mission of legal education, which opens the door full of new opportunities for us, and for the great support and care that help us thrive and shine. Today, we celebrate our graduation with the deep love of our families and friends, here and afar. My dear friends are here, and my families are cheering online. Now we wave goodbye to law school and go on our next chapters. No matter where we go, I hope we can carry the characters of the law school with us, and we stay connected. Thank you, my dear friends and fellow graduates. I wish us all a bright and fruitful future. Thank you.
The JD class chose two speakers, both known for their leadership and scholarship in our community. Delorean Forbes served as the editor-in-chief of the Arizona Journal of International and Comparative Law and as president of the Black Law Student Association. After the bar exam, he will commission as a judge advocate in the U.S. Navy Judge Advocate General's Corps. This year in particular, we were all beneficiaries of Delorean's hard work on the college's COVID task force and helping us build an ongoing forum for discussions and action about racial justice. He says, "The pandemic created a unique obstacle to my legal education by forcing me and the rest of the College of Law to adapt to an online learning environment and forego many of the social interactions that are critical components of the law school experience. Additionally, the post-George Floyd civil rights moment gave BALSA the momentum we needed to further educate the community about racial justice and advocate for necessary reform. I give you Delorean Forbes."
Thank you, President Robbins, Dean Miller, College of Law faculty and administration, guests, and most importantly, my fellow graduates. I am deeply honored and humbled to be given this opportunity to address you all on this magnificent occasion. I would like to begin by saying that I cannot possibly give this moment the credit that it is due. As only one student among such a varied and esteemed group, I cannot speak to the diversity of experiences, trials, and triumphs that the various members of this graduating class have gone through to reach this moment. This exceptionally diverse class is composed of students from multiple countries, indeed multiple continents, and from numerous walks of life. Tonight's ceremony will feature many first-generation legal practitioners proudly walking across this stage, alongside migrants and the children of migrants, indigenous people, veterans, parents, caretakers, and a multitude of others. Various members of this class are survivors of trauma, poverty, as well as housing and food insecurity, while all of us have had to navigate the unique difficulties of earning a law degree in the midst of a raging pandemic unprecedented in the modern era. Indeed, if you all in the audience remember nothing else from this evening's event, remember this. The University of Arizona James E. Rogers College of Law class of 2021 is a class of champions. Each of us has undergone our own unique odyssey, titanic in its scope, to reach the milestone of achievement that we celebrate tonight. Every student that you see here this evening is a hero in their own right. Their lives matter. Their experiences matter, and their accomplishments deserve the utmost celebration and reverence. Now, we have each walked our own paths to get to this stage tonight, but we've also had some help along the way. We earned these degrees with help from faculty, staff members, mentors, parents, grandparents, and partners. But most importantly, we earned these degrees. We walked this long road not often traveled by helping each other. Now, over the past 3 years, I have been moved beyond measure by the sense of community, brotherhood, and sisterhood that this class has embodied. At every obstacle, at every challenge, we have banded together to rise to the occasion and meet the moment. At a time of great peril and uncertainty, as well as national and international division, this class unflinchingly came together, united, such that even the very forces of nature itself could not tear us asunder. Indeed, the greatest gift that this law college has bestowed upon me is not the phenomenal education I have received, nor the opportunities that I have been offered. Rather, it has been the chance to know and learn from all of you, my brothers and sisters in the law. I consider it a divine honor and privilege to know each and every one of you. You are all wise and gentle. You are treasures of humanity. And the legal community is all the better for having accepted you into its ranks. I could not be prouder to address you all for the first time tonight as my colleagues. Tonight, we will see our lives transformed as our degrees are conferred upon us and we begin this remarkable new adventure as legal professionals. But I'd like to take a moment to remember the monumental duty that awaits all of us after this ceremony concludes. Last May, following the tragic death of George Floyd, I challenged our law student community to remember the power, privilege, and attendant responsibility that are inherent to our degrees. I challenge you all to remain aware of the special obligation to the public that we as legal professionals have, and to fight for equal justice and embody the type of positive change that we want to see in society. Tonight, I would like to conclude by reaffirming that challenge and offering a few more. The line between justice and injustice now runs through us. And while the long arc of the law bends toward justice, that bend is not inexorable. It is our responsibility, no one else's, to ensure the law's continued bend toward justice and to ensure that this justice is applied equitably. Because justice without equity is simply not justice. Tonight, I call upon you all, my class of champions, to give a voice to those who have long been denied one throughout your careers. I call on you to seek reparatory justice that remedies past and enduring wrongs and to stand in opposition to the notion that might has to make right. I implore you to be more tolerant and fairer than legal generations that came before us and to leave the door just a bit more open than it was when you arrived. And I challenge you all to summon the courage to be the champions of tomorrow, to be unafraid to stand in history on the path of the righteous. I'd like to once again express my deep gratitude for this opportunity to address you this evening. You all are a truly remarkable class, and I cannot wait to return to the law college one day, perhaps many years from now, and see your faces decorating the halls as monuments to the compassion, equity, and love that you have shepherded throughout the earth. May God bless you all, and thank you for a spectacular 3 years. Thank you all so much.
Thank you, Delorean. These are certainly times that call on each of us to find our strength, resolve, and power. Katie Derrig found it in the abiding support of family and friends. She says, "I would not be where I am today if I did not have a strong support network of amazing people who helped me keep going when I didn't think I could go anymore. I would also think back to the absolute confidence my dad had in me to do great things, and I would power through whatever I was facing, knowing how proud he would be of me." While here, Katie served admirably as the editor-in-chief of the Arizona Law Review and worked in the Domestic Violence Law Clinic. She will be an associate at Lewis Rocha in Phoenix starting this fall. Please join me in welcoming Katie Derrig.
Hello, everyone, and thank you for being here or attending online to support us graduates. I know, at least in my own personal experience, that all of you friends and family who have supported us through our studies have been invaluable in helping us to get where we are today. And so I thank you all for your support. I also would like to thank you for letting us vent about cold calls and professors that wouldn't let us take our outlines into 4-hour-long finals. Looking at you, Professor Woods. I would like to start off with a quote from author Leigh Bardugo that really resonates with me. "Sometimes the only way to get justice is to take it for yourself." Now, I'll be completely honest and admit that I've never read the book that this quote comes from. I'm really hoping it's not something weird, but I did look into it, and I'm pretty sure it's just a fantasy novel. Anyway, regardless of the context, the point still stands. If I have learned anything in law school, it is that justice does not always come easy. And you cannot wait for others, even those in positions of authority, to step in and administer that justice. Sometimes, you just have to take it for yourself. As law students, we have been given a great gift to assist in the administration of justice. However, this gift also comes with the responsibility to take action when we see injustice. We no longer have the excuse of falling prey to the bystander effect and waiting for someone else to fix things. We are the fixers. Standing here in front of you all today, there is no doubt in my mind that each and every one of us is ready and capable to step into that role. You are all so incredibly bright, talented, and skilled, and I'm sure you'll do great things as we move on into the real world. But being able to see an injustice and step forward to rectify it requires not only the skills that we have learned here, or our intelligence, or our experience, it also requires our compassion. Through the trials and tribulations of the last few years, I have experienced firsthand the level of compassion that each of you possess. The selflessness and complete readiness to assist our peers in need of so many of you is inspiring. I want to give a non-exhaustive list of some of the things that I have witnessed. Offering up your homes to displaced students. Giving shoulders to cry on when the stress was too much. Buying each other lunches when we got sick of free blackjack pizza. Sitting with each other in solidarity as we went through separations, loss, and frustrations. Helping those in need who couldn't find help anywhere else, and so much more. Not only did you all display such great amounts of compassion through hard times, but we also lifted each other up and celebrated our victories, whether that was getting a job we really wanted, acing a tough class, or even just making it through a hard day. My hope is that we carry that compassion with us as we all start this chapter in our lives. No matter where we end up, we as legal professionals have a duty to our clients, to the public, into the justice system to improve access to and the quality of the administration of justice. Looking at the world through a lens of compassion will not only allow us to do this, it will compel us to. Lofty goals and aspirations aside, I want to congratulate all of us, the James E. Rogers College of Law, class of 2021, for making it here today. I certainly know that it was not easy, but we all did it, and we all did it together. Now we can go out into the world, fully qualified to finally answer our friends and family's burning legal questions with the standard law school response. It depends. Thank you all, and good luck.
A few years ago, a prospective law student stopped in to see me with her young family and a spouse who was also in law school at another law school. I am proud to say we recruited them both. Paulene Abeyta's drive, energy, and compassion impressed me immediately. And as I have come to know her better, my esteem has only grown. We are delighted tonight to welcome the United States Secretary of the Interior, Deb Haaland, who will be delivering virtual remarks. Paulene's efforts secured Secretary Haaland's appearance. The story of how their connection developed into a friendship is one that Paulene will tell you and demonstrates the power of engagement and connection. Paulene.
Thank you, Dean Miller. Yat A, good evening. I grew up in the small Navajo community of Tojale, where it was rare to see Native women in public office or even Native women lawyers. I, however, was fortunate enough to be raised by a family who believed it could and would happen. Several years ago, I saw a Native American woman running for Lieutenant Governor of New Mexico. I reached out to her immediately. I shared how excited and proud I was of her and asked how me and my family could help, because in Navajo culture, we volunteer our entire family. She wrote back, she thanked me for the message, and she told me one of the best ways to help is to get involved. She specifically said, "You've got to register people to vote. Help them get to the polls. And you need to run for office." And that's it.
That's when she activated me. After working with her on her campaign for Congress, I realized that this is what she does. She activates. She activates everyday people to step up and serve. She activates tough issues that need to be discussed. She activates movements and inspires change. She brought that same momentum as a congresswoman and has not stopped. President Biden took notice of this and selected her to lead the Department of the Interior. Her secretary nomination acceptance speech is one of the most prominent moments in Native American history, one I will never forget. Now, I ask the class of 2021, our guests, and the University of Arizona to please join me in welcoming our commencement speaker, the Secretary of the United States Department of the Interior, and my mentor, Ms. Deb Haaland.
Thank you for that kind introduction, Paulene. I can still remember when you told me you were going to law school. I'm so happy you took the plunge, and congratulations on your tremendous accomplishment. Hello, everyone. President Robbins, Dean Miller, faculty, students, family, friends, and supporters of the U of A James E. Rogers College of Law graduating class of 2021. I'm grateful for the privilege to share some remarks, life lessons, and words of hope with you on this special day, recognizing the hard work it takes to get through law school. I fondly remember my years at the University of New Mexico School of Law, starting out at the Pre-Law Summer Institute, and then my steep rise to secretary and then vice chair of the Native American Law Student Association, where my primary mission was to raise funds for our organization through pozole sales. Everyone attending this virtual ceremony knows that law school isn't for the faint of heart. You have to be fierce to get through long nights of reading, writing, and studying while taking care of your children, tending to the care of elderly family members, or maybe saying goodbye to a loved one, as I had to when my dad passed away during my second year. Take time to remember all of the people who helped you to get here. My mother cooked me many meals, and my sister would send me a $20 bill in the mail occasionally. Any educational endeavor is a family affair. I know that your families have sacrificed right along next to you. Today is a big step, but it's just the beginning. Whether you've secured employment, are planning to pursue another degree, or are waiting to find out your bar exam score before you market yourself, my hope is that you find your passion and pursue it so that we can build communities and a better country for our future generations. With a law degree comes the power to advocate for those less fortunate, fix broken systems, fight for justice, stand up for the rule of law, and follow due process. How you decide to use your experience here is entirely up to you. I'd like you to ponder the question of what your passion is. Why did you decide that law school was right for you? What issue wakes you up in the middle of the night? There isn't just one traditional route to success, and not everything will be a momentous stand. Each of you will find your path. For me, I found my passion advocating for voting rights. I made it part of my life's work to ensure more Native people knew how and where to vote. That led me down a winding path from UNM Law School to phone volunteer to unsuccessful lieutenant gubernatorial candidate to historic congressional service to where I sit today as the first Native American cabinet secretary in our country's history. My law degree has served me well, and even though there were setbacks, I found my way to make an impact, and you can find yours too. With everything that's going on in the world, my hope remains strong because we come from communities that believe in the promise of future generations deserving to be more successful than the one before it. When your grandparents went to work every morning to support their families, they had you in mind. When you came into the world, your parents immediately started planning for your future. I know this because it's exactly what happened when my child was born. We each have a responsibility to make them proud. So I'll leave you with this question. What is your passion for progress? How will you use your law degree from the James E. Rogers College of Law to pursue that passion for the good of all of us and our environment? Our country and our world are counting on you. Be fierce and don't let anything hold you back. Thank you.
We will now begin to give you the moment that we worried we wouldn't have this year. That celebratory and well-earned walk across this stage. Candidates for graduate certificates, MPS, and MLS degrees should assemble. It looks like you have, physically distanced. No one's got a ruler at the side of the stage. We are delighted this year to recognize the achievements of students across a range of programs, from focused short-term study to deep long-term scholarship that prepares graduates for the highest levels of academic and public policy careers. Our graduate certificate programs in health law, regulatory science, and Indigenous governance offer students the chance to learn from national and international leaders in a concentrated curriculum. Many of our current students who undertake study as part of their longer-term academic program. But many are working professionals who want to expand their knowledge, undertake new professional responsibilities, or keep current with the legal issues that define their respective professional worlds. We will now present candidates for the graduate certificates of Master in Professional Studies in Indigenous Governance and the Master of Legal Studies. Graduates, in most years, I look forward to enthusiastic handshakes as you cross the stage. One year, a graduate picked me up about 3 feet off the ground. I hope no one would think about that again. But this year, President Robbins and I will limit ourselves to slight bows, contactless high fives, very enthusiastic eye contact. Please stop at the center of the stage at the Block A for a photo, and then pick up your diploma cover from Deans Jordan Curtis and Brooks, just off stage.
Samantha Warman. Gabriella Santarami. Carrie Lee Ramsey. Wanda Atkins. Darian Singer. Lewis at school. Veronica Garibe. Lynn Dominguez. Celeste Martinez. and Julia Madrid. Anna Rosa Amaya. Ruth J. Manuel Alejandro Moreno.
Harry John Aaron.
Maddie King. Amina as Anastasi Gino. Catherine Nawaka. Christina Randolph. Emily Andrea Ortiz. Stephanie Catherine Klitsch. Regina Collins. Yatsina Ramirez Acosta. Yaritza J. Ibarra.
Harry John Aaron.
Tania Lee White. Tevin Wallace. Daniel Andres Dominguez. Lauren Olivia Easter. Paloma Melo Raro.
The LLM degree evidences study beyond the first law degree. And this year, we were again delighted to have a cohort of students from around the globe.
Charles Benaza. George Achonu. Chad Abeyta.
The Doctor of Juridical Science, or SJD, is the highest law degree conferred at the University of Arizona, reflecting significant study beyond the JD. SJD graduates in Indigenous Peoples Law and Policy, or International Trade and Business Law, will now take their place among the world's scholarly societies, both teaching and the next generation of students and creating the next generation of insight, knowledge, and discovery. I am pleased to note that Arizona has been recognized as one of the top universities nationally in awarding PhDs and SJDs to women and people of color.
Patricia Anthony Casinda.
Benedict Maige Anchala.
Jingyuan Zhou.
Yi Shu. Why Yu Shao.
We now call candidates to the stage for the Juris Doctor degree.
Jefferson Abbey. Tanner Priest. Theophilos Bodhi Abulurin. Andrew R. Goldsmith. Kevin Godfrey. Seth Aaron Brimley. Lauren R. McMullen. Nathaniel Goodman. Ruben Salcido. Philip Grosjean Rohde. Rory Bennett. Nolan Andresen. Valerie E. Douglas. Carissa Pryor. Devora L. Kalani. Zara Kazemi. Mariam Azimi. Rafaela Pearl Safarian. Annabelle Barraza. Arizona Baskin. Braylon Barnett. Ichiro Dennis Kasama Sanders. Alan Lechte. Stephen J. Bagger. Christian D. Betcher. Benjamin L. Champion. Danica Huss. Daniel Tillman. Miguel Munoz. Zachary Preston Taylor. Sarah Sanders. Stephanie Danielle Baldwin. Joshua Preston Hilliard. Timothy Desjarlais. Gabriela Marisol Elizondo Craig. Andrea Sharp. Carly Marshall. Paige E. Scalf. Yewan Lee. John Gin Kwan. Myrna G. Sider. Taylor McGrew. Thomas Anagnostis. Jake Smith. Samantha Walker. Brian Truby. Margot Baranis Edgecombe. Raina Araby. Christina Billhartz. Natalie Truard. Crystal De La Osa. Thomas McNeely. John Frick. Neil A. Berglund. Glynis Anderson. Nicole S. Brongeau. Jennifer Putnam Ohms. Dakota Francis. Tian Fan. Vu No. Claire McGuire. Mario Rios. Kyle Buckley. Melinda L. Bonson. Yu Ling Chen Liu. Henry Eccles. Casey Peel. Pamela M. Rioles. Bethany R. Munson. Sigifredo Perez. Nayeli Woods. Natalie Marlene Gonzalez. Lauren LeCure. David Herrera. Anmol Rawat. Kenny Kim. Garrett Tobin. Jamie T. First. Morgan Bigelow. Jacqueline Marzaka. Ezekiel Peterson. Castile Cox. Katrina Wilkinson. Shah Hussein. Garrick Ellis Nowak. Rosa M. Leon. Chang Chu Zhou. Chao Han. Sarah Myers. Thank you so much. Kathleen Derrig. Michelle Paulene Abeyta. Delorean L. Forbes. Joshua Richards. Tyler Thorne. Christina Poletti. Hui Yang. Chi Rao Nhiet.
And at this time, we're going to honor those students who could not join us this evening.
Perry John Aaron. Amarachukwu Amichi. Kayla Richelle Arrington. Brandy Elizabeth Blanchett. Nicholas Cosmo Blum. Denise Booker. Jamiz S. Bradley. John W. Bruno Jr. Valeria Boot. Leslie Valerie Cuellar. Kathleen Derrig. Lauren Olivia Easter. Donna Ennis. Luke R. Erickson. Brittany Ariana Aseller. Susan Phelan. Michael Gaspar. Nathan Hamilton. Alexandra Harris. Justice Johnson. Julia Uhave. Kamari McLaurin. Paloma Melo Haro. Jotika Menon. Miguel Jaramillo Moreno. Sarah Myers. Matthew T. Nolte. Victoria Mary Palmisano. Joy Poet Jen Parker. Zonia C. Pasmino Brown. Alejandra Pence. Carrie Pearson. Bethany Prim. Vince Redhouse. Amy Seeley. Nicole Elise Steiner. Stacy Amber Thacker. Vincent Unwa-Rakor. Kaylee Van Alstein. Changfeng Xu. Greg Washburn. Luke Whitman.
So, given the oddities of these times and the different setting, and let me check, is there anyone here who expected to walk across the stage but did not? Now is your time. Okay. So a final note before I ask President Robbins to stand and do the formal conferral of degrees on everyone, which is to note that graduation is always a night about both endings and beginnings, a theme your classmates raised. So I want to briefly acknowledge some changes within the college community. Colleagues who've worked with us for decades are retiring. Faculty Services Librarian Maureen Garman retires this year after 24 years at our college. Leah Sandwell Weiss, Reference Librarian and Professor of Practice, retired in December after 20 years. And Barbara Lopez, who has led our faculty support office for 16 years, is retiring this year. There are also two faculty retirements. Professor John Swain retired in December after 22 years of teaching, all but two of those at Arizona, and has since moved to Vietnam. Finally, Regents Professor Robert Glennon is retiring this year. Robert has been at Arizona since 1985 and has built an international reputation as a leading policy and scholarly voice on water law and policy. He's the recipient of two National Science Foundation grants. He served as advisors to governments, corporations, think tanks, NGOs, and law firms looking to solve the problems, the profound problems of water and sustainability. At the college, his service has also been profound and invaluable, and he has affected the lives of his students beyond measure in number and in depth. With that, President Robbins, I now have the honor to present all of the candidates who have met the requirements for the following degrees. Please stand, all candidates. The Doctor of Juridical Science, Master of Laws, Juris Doctor, Master of Professional Studies, Master of Legal Studies, and graduate certificates.
I am so thrilled we got to do this in person and that your loved ones and family could be here with you. Well done. So by the authority vested in me by the Arizona Board of Regents and acting on the recommendation of the faculty at the conclusion of your academic coursework, I confer upon each of you the appropriate degree with all the attendant rights and responsibilities. Please accept my warmest congratulations.
To signify, there is one rite of graduation, which is to move the tassel from the right to the left side of your TAMS.
Congratulations to all of our new graduates. Could everyone please rise and join in singing the alma mater? You will find the words on the screen. Paige Mills from the College of Fine Arts recorded this earlier and will lead us, accompanied by alumnus Russell Ronnebaum. As we conclude the 157th commencement of the University of Arizona and the James E. Rogers College of Law 2021 convocation, you may henceforth consider yourselves Wildcats for life. At this time, I invite my university colleagues and esteemed guests to leave the stage. All of us who are left, there's not many of us left. Please remain in your seats until the platform party has exited, and we ask graduates and families to please maintain social distancing as we exit the Davis Sports Center and meet each other well outside the venue. Congratulations again, and thank you for celebrating this special evening together. Good night.
For those graduates who did not have their slides on the screen, we're going to go through them now. Congratulations.